What? What?
There, there. Sit back, little Irizana. You're safe.
I was dreaming.
You have slept long. That is good. It helps the healing. The medics are pleased with your progress.
Where am I?
In a hospital.
The last thing I remember, I was in the arena.
You won a great victory. People have been yelling your name in the streets. Many have won great sums.
Did you?
I'm in a room, just like you. I'm not allowed to bet.
But you did. I see it in your eyes.
We Abiru need all the help we can get. I have 3 cubs. Now all will have enough food this winter. All will have warm clothing. And my mate will not have to work the dangerous third shift for the rest of the year.
You really did place a wager.
Shh, Irizana. Do not let the Vis medics know you are so alert. They will sedate you again to keep you from making trouble. Act drowsy, and they will not drug you.
Thank you. Why are you helping me?
We Aruns should help one another. You're one of the Hiva clan, aren't you?
I don't know. I was taken too young from my mother. I don't know anything about being an Arun.
I think you are, Hiva. It's in the shape of your eyes.
What's your name? You're so kind.
Fula. And kindness is the Arun way.
There's so much about our race that I want to know.
Oh, you poor Irizana.
Why do you call me that?
It means beloved girl cub. The last born. When a female Arun knows she will bear no more cubs, then she turns a special affection on the one born to her last of all.
Who taught you all this? Was it your mother?
Yes. She lives here still, in the same tenement as me.
I wish I could meet her. I wish I could learn about...
I told my mother about that necklace you wear. She says you are blessed to have it.
Can she tell me more? Can you tell me anything about the Aruns?
Shh. Someone's coming. If you promise to be very, very careful, I will record a data crystal for you, with the old tellings, and perhaps some of the prayer songs of my clan. Now, I must go.
Thank you, thank you!
Hey. Anyone got a spare Arun around here?
El Robin!
Yeah. I got sent to pack your things, Goldie. We're going home. Only first we gotta get past the crowds. You got quite a following after that last fight.
Stop it, I ruined the team.
No, you stuffed the howl, Goldie. Ely went rogue and you took care of her. No one's blaming you. In fact, you're team leader now.
I don't know if I want to take her place. They drove her mad.
Listen, there's stuff about Ely you don't know. She wouldn't fight when the Blues first bought her. They bought her for her size. She'd been brought up free.
Free? But all Aruns are born slaves.
Well, ain't so, Goldie. You born in the city, sure. You born outside in the wild places. Who finds you? Not the Vs. They're too lazy. They only go after those that make trouble. I hear there's whole villages on Vismail where Biru folk live. They move around a lot, like...
Nomads.
Yeah, right. Like nomads. Gotta keep ahead of the patrol sweeps. Anyway, patrollers got Ely's family, killed him, and sold her to the Blues.
Why didn't you tell me this before? I would have felt differently, acted differently.
Yeah, and she would have killed you. She was half mad and conditioned to kill before you ever showed up, Goldie. You wouldn't have had a chance.
But now that I'm in her place, what's going to become of me?
Well, whatever it is, Goldie, I'm sure it's going to be interesting.
El Robin's words proved truer than he could know. Apris returned home to Ferry and Sahiro. During the off-season, her wounds healed, and she entered her second year as a gladiator, as the team leader of the famous Blues. During that season, she won fight after fight, but her biggest battles were invisible to the V's audience. Thanks to the data crystal she'd been given, Ampress learned more and more about her Arun past, and with each bit of information, her resolve grew stronger. Her people had been free, and would be so again. At each planet where she fought, Ampress struggled to establish a network of Abiru's spies and confidants. For the first few years, the Abiru ignored her, then they feared her. But slowly, as the Arun turned into a seasoned veteran of 3, then 4, then 5 years, they began to trust her words. With the help of El Robin, Ampress sought to spread her vision of freedom, she tried to convince all Aroons, Kelths, Miles, and all the other slave races that there was hope, if not for them, then for their offspring. For the V's empire was crumbling. Technologies continued to collapse. With each passing season, more jump gates failed. Vidcasts relayed news of increasing trouble on the empire's borders. Prosperity reached fewer hands, and many aristocratic households, now bankrupt, cast out their Abiro slaves to fend for themselves or starve. Gangs grew bolder, preying on everyone in the ghettos, and even venturing out of the slums and into the homes of the V's. By the time Empress had reached her seventh season as a gladiator, the economic collapse increased until it reached even into the seemingly inexhaustible accounts of Lord Gallard, owner of the Blues.